إذا قرئ القرآن فاستمعوا له وأنصتوا لعلكم ترحمون.
إذا قرئ القرآن فاستمعوا له وأنصتوا لعلكم ترحمون.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Welcome to another episode of Quran Circle 4, where we listen to verses from the Quran, reflect upon the meanings of it. We're talking about messengers of Allah. This set of episodes, we're talking about messengers of Allah, how the Quran talks about them, history, something that is part of their life, to look into the benefits and the lessons learned. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most wise. Whenever something is mentioned in the Quran as a story, it's not like how the human beings, they want to listen to a story. It's not a story that people would pass some good times and that's the end of it, but rather Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He would narrate the stories for a reason. That is for the living generation, the ones that would recite the Quran would benefit from it, would take from it lessons. That's why the only things that are mentioned in the story is the benefiting things. Nothing that would not be have any benefit will be mentioned in the stories that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran. In this episode, inshallah ta'ala, we'll go through some of the verses in the Quran that talks about Prophet Lut alayhi salam. And Prophet Lut alayhi salam, he was sent to people that are so corrupt, and they committed something that is so evil that there was no precedence to it before it in any nations before, as we would see inshallah ta'ala. And this is a sin that is continuously to happen, one of the worst sins that can be committed on the face of earth as far as the sins are concerned. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent him, and he called his people to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone and to purify themselves. And the people opposed this as the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, always with the messengers of Allah. And at the end, we know the outcome, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved Lut alayhi salam and his people, and the disbelievers and those sinners, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed them. But before we start, inshallah ta'ala, I would like to introduce the reciters with us today. We're delighted to have with us Sheikh Rajab Abdul Tawab. Welcome to the program.
Welcome, Sheikh.
Barakallahu fi. Also, we have with us Sheikh Karim Saudi. Welcome to the program.
Welcome, Sheikh.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you for coming. And also Sheikh Ahmad Rajab. Welcome to the program, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to reward you. We're delighted to have you with us, and this is a great opportunity for us to really listen to the Quran and to benefit from it, and for you to get rewards by reciting the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is an advice for myself and the viewers to take advantage of this, to listen to the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to reflect upon the meanings of it, and to make the Quran cure, because it's cure to our hearts. And then we'll get to know some of the meanings that we need to learn from the story of Lut alayhi salam. We'll start inshallah ta'ala with some verses in Surah Hud, with Sheikh Rajab Abdul Tawab reciting for us something about Lut alayhi salam and his people from Surah Hud. Please go ahead.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Walamma ja'at rusuluna Lutan si'a bihim wadaqa bihim dhar'a wa qala hadha yawmun 'asib wa ja'ahu qawmuhu yuhra'una ilayhi wa ja'ahu qawmuhu yuhra'una ilayhi wa min qablu kanu ya'maluna as-sayyi'at qala ya qawmi ha'ula'i banati qala ya qawmi ha'ula'i banati hunna atuharu lakum fattaqullaha فاتقوا الله ولا تخزوني في ضيفي فاتقوا الله ولا تخزوني في ضيفي أليس منكم رجل رشيد قالوا لقد علمت ما لنا في بناتك من حق وإنك لتعلم ما نريد قال لو أن لي بكم قوة أو آوي إلى ركن شديد
ما شاء الله. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. These verses are verses that brings the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our hearts. This is verses where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about the destruction of the people of Hud. These are people of Lut. These people were committing one of the most evil sins ever. Something against the nature of the human beings, as we all know. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warned them through Prophet Lut alayhi salam. And when they refused and they turned away from against the truth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the angels to Lut alayhi salam in the form of men, that they were very handsome. And once Lut alayhi salam, he saw them, he was so much disturbed because he knows how his people would react to this and they would want to commit the sin with them. And he said that this is a difficult day for him. And his people immediately start coming and he knows exactly what they're coming for. And they used to do the evil deeds that they used to do. They're coming in that state of sin. They're coming and they commit the sins in their gatherings and so on. And Lut alayhi salam, as the verses explained to us, the state that he was in, the state of difficulty that he was going through. And he said to them that, قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ هَؤُلَاءِ بَنَاتِهُنَّ أَطْهَرُ لَكُمْ. That means the females among his tribe. He does not refer to his own daughters. He's referring to the females in his tribe. These are the ones that you're supposed to seek, meaning to have wives and so on and so forth. And of course they refused and they told him, you know exactly what we want. And he said that I wish I have some form of power or that I would rely and flee to such a strong reliance, which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's relying on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, seeking help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala against his people. And these people were someone that their own fitrah, their own natural way has been corrupted so much, and they were basically seeking their own destruction by these evil acts. And this is something that the more it's repeated throughout humanity, the more that the people are basically inviting the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be upon them. So again, the verses explains how Lut alayhi salam was going through difficult times with his people, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him steadfastness, and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save them, as we would hear more in the verses of the surah and other surahs in the Quran. And with Sheikh Karim Saudi will recite to us more inshallah ta'ala with the surah Hud.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Qalu ya Lut inna rusul rabbika يصلوا إليك فأسر بأهلك بقطع من الليل ولا يلتفت منكم أحد إلا امرأتك إنه مصيبها ما أصابهم إن موعدهم الصبح أليس الصبح بقريب إنه مصيبها ما أصابهم إن موعدهم الصبح أليس الصبح بقريب فلما جاء أمرنا جعلنا عاليها نافلها فلما جاء أمرنا جعلنا عاليها سافلها وأمطرنا عليها حجارة من سجيل منضود مسومة عند ربك وما هي من الظالمين ببعيد.
إن شاء الله. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is explaining how the destruction and the punishment that was afflicted to the people of Lut as a result of their evil actions. But before that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, continuing what we heard in the beginning, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He sent these angels for the destruction of the people of Lut, and these angels, they comforted Lut alayhi salam, and they told him that these people would never be able to do whatever they are planning and they're desiring. And they ordered him to leave during the night, and nobody is to turn his face. And the ulama talked about this matter in many different ways, but because of the time and because of what the verses basically is just saying, how Lut alayhi salam, he accepted this and he listened to these instructions. But they told him, except your wife. The wife of Lut alayhi salam was among those who were perished and destroyed. It was said that she would aid the people with their sins. She approved their sin. She did not disapprove of it. She did not forbid this type of evil. She approved it to her people. So as a result of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed her with them. And this is what the verses are saying, إِنَّهُ مُصِيبُهَا مَا أَصَابَهُمْ, that she will be afflicted with what they will be afflicted with. And the time for them that will be the punishment will be in the morning. أَلَيْسَ الصُّبُحُ بِقَرِيبٍ, it's very near. And this is a powerful statement, that whenever people are threatened or given the threat of the punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the matter is near. Even if it's the entire life of a person. We heard before how Nuh alayhi salam, the punishment took years and years. Nuh alayhi salam invited his people for hundreds of years. So the same thing when someone lives on the face of earth, 60, 70, 80 years compared to everlasting punishment, it's nothing. It's a very short period of time. And therefore, people, when they have the proper wisdom and they look into the matter seriously, there's nothing on the face of earth that is worth it for the person to continue to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when the matter came to them, when the order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for them to be punished, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that these cities of Lut alayhi salam, the people, those who are evildoers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the upper part of it the lower part, meaning that it was flipped on the other side and smashed. And there's a hadith of the Prophet ﷺ that explains this, that Jibreel alayhi salam, he lifted the four cities of the people of Lut by the tip of one of his wings. And we know that Jibreel alayhi salam, he had 600 wings. The tip of one of his wings, the weakest part of a wing, he raised that up all the way to the skies till the angels would hear the barking of the dogs. And then it was flipped outside, upside down, and then it would let to fall down on the earth. Severe destruction for them as a result of their evil actions. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that clearly here in the Quran. And it was sent while they're falling with stones, that fires and so on them to destroy them and to wipe them completely. See how the severe punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Severe punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for something that these people were desiring, that is something that is so evil, something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbid. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from sins. Sins are the means of destruction for nations. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said something in the last verse that we heard, something that brings the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the hearts. He said, وَمَا هِيَ مِنَ الظَّلِمِينَ بِبَعِيدٍ, that the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not far off from the wrongdoers. The nations before they were punished, and the wrongdoers of today, the wrongdoers at the time of the Prophet ﷺ, the punishment is not far off from them. They will be punished if they continue to be disobedient to Allah and spread corruption on the face of earth and so on. The same outcome, the same destiny will be for those who disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all. More with some verses that talks about Lut alayhi salam, and this time from Surah Al-Hijr and with Sheikh Ahmad Rajab. Please recite for us, inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. فلما جاء آل لوط المرسلون قال إنكم قوم منكرون قالوا بل جئناك بما كانوا فيه يمترون وأتيناك بالحق وإنا لصادقون فأسر بأهلك بقطع من الليل واتبع أدبارهم ولا يلتفت منكم أحد وامضوا حيث تؤمرون وقضينا إليه ذلك الأمر أن دابر هؤلاء مقطوع مصبحين.
ما شاء الله. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. Again, these are verses in the Quran that brings the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The messengers from Allah, the angels, they went to the people of Lut. Lut alayhi salam, he did not know them. So he said, who are you? I do not know you. And they said to him that they came to him as a messenger, as people to cause the destruction to the people of Lut. The thing that they were in doubt of, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent these angels to destroy the people of Lut. And they came with the truth, and they are truthful ones. So again, they ordered Lut alayhi salam to leave during the night and not to look behind him to see what's happening to his people when the destruction is being upon them, and to follow what they have been ordered to do. Lut alayhi salam, he was the nephew of Ibrahim alayhi salam. He believed in Ibrahim alayhi salam. He followed Ibrahim alayhi salam, and then he was sent as a messenger of Allah, and he fulfilled his work. And you can imagine, again, he's in the midst of all of these evil people that they are committing these evil sins. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punished them, and he told them that in the morning they will be punished. And as we will hear, inshallah ta'ala, the continuation of this in Surah Al-Hijr, and how the people rejoiced and so on, and how the desire that they have made them completely blind, not aware of what they're doing. And this is what the sins might do to the hearts of the people. They become in state of forgetfulness so much, and the heart becomes so hard, that the people would enjoy the sins and disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and not aware of the evil that they're doing and the outcome that is waiting for them. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is warning us. And this is something that we see nowadays in this world that we live in today. It's happening. And we have to be concerned and have the kindness and the goodness towards the people by advising them, by warning them against the evil consequences of the sins. Because the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we heard, He's the most merciful subhanahu wa ta'ala. But He's the most just subhanahu wa ta'ala if people disobey His orders. We'll continue, inshallah ta'ala, with more of the verses in Surah Al-Hijr and other surahs in the Quran that talks about Prophet Lut alayhi salam and his people, but right after the break, so stay tuned.
وَإِذَا قُرِئَ الْقُرْآنُ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنصِتُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ.
I think it's such a big deal to say a white lie from time to time, or to make joke of somebody just having a bit of fun. It can it be such a major deal?
Well, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us that an individual may say a word without paying any attention to it that would take him down in the hell, in hell pits, more than the distance of a 70 years for a traveler.
I don't want to go to the hellfire. How can I save myself?
To save yourself, you have to work hard for it. The Prophet ﷺ guaranteed paradise for those who do not want to go to hell.
Sheikh, can you tell me about the details of what exactly must I do and what should I preserve in order to go to paradise?
It sounds a little bit easy, but it isn't. The Prophet said, alayhi salatu wasalam, whoever guarantees what's between his jaws and what's between his thighs, meaning that he observes and preserves them, the tongue and the private parts, I guarantee him Jannah.
So my dear brothers and my dear sisters, we have a beautiful series called Mind Your Tongue, Journeys with our well-respected Sheikh Asim Al-Hakim. He's going to be at the receiving end of our questions, and inshallah ta'ala he's going to do a fantastic job of explaining all the different concepts and how we can purify ourselves and be the best Muslims that we can.
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Welcome back, and still with the story of Lut عليه السلام and the verses in the Quran that talks about Lut عليه السلام. As we heard, he was sent to his people, inviting them to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone and to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the crime of sodomy, and how they went against the nature that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the human beings with. And how Lut alayhi salam, he suffered a great deal with his people, but they refused. And the desire that they had, the evil desire, the sinful desire that they had, made them blind from seeing the truth. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran about this situation and about the destruction of the people of Lut, and how for the people to take from this a lesson to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as we heard in Surah Hud and Surah Al-Hijr, things of that nature, something that for us to reflect upon. Sins that keep on coming to the face of earth, in which people need to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to be dutiful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to take lessons from it. We'll start again in this segment, inshallah ta'ala, with Surah Al-Hijr, continuing what's mentioned about Prophet Lut alayhi salam and his people, and then we'll reflect upon the verses that we hear, inshallah ta'ala. So with Sheikh Rajab Abdul Tawab, please recite for us Surah Al-Hijr.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Waja'a ahlul madinati yastabshirun. Qala inna ha'ula واتقوا الله ولا تخزون قالوا أولم ننهك عن العالمين واتقوا الله ولا تخزون قالوا أولم ننهك عن العالمين قال هؤلاء لعمرك إنهم لفي سكرتهم يعمهون لعمرك إنهم لفي سكرتهم يعمهون فأخذتهم الصيحة مشرقين فجعلنا عاليها سافلها فجعلنا عاليها سافلها وأمطرنا عليهم حجارة من سجيل إن في ذلك لآيات للمتوسمين وإنها لبسبيل مقيم في ذلك لآية للمؤمنين.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards you, a very nice recitation about the people of Lut. When they heard about the guests, these angels, they came rushing to Lut alayhi salam, and they were rejoicing. Why? Because of the evil intentions that they have, seeking the evil sin to be committed with the guests of Lut alayhi salam. So he said to them, قَالَ إِنَّ هَؤُلَاءِ ضَيْفِي فَلَا تَفْضَحُونَ. These are my guests, do not expose me, do not cause harm to them. They are my guests, and we know how we are importantly for us to take care of our guests. So they wanted to come and attack the guests of Lut alayhi salam, and he reminded them to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and not to disgrace him. And then their response was, قَالُوا أَوَلَمْ نَنْهَكَ عَنِ الْعَالَمِينَ. They said, didn't we forbid you from having guests? Basically, this is what they said to him. So he said to them, here are the women in your town. These are the people that you need to seek your pleasure with, meaning your wives. These are the proper way for you to fulfill your desire, not the evil way that you are seeking. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about the people of Lut, لَعَمْرُكَ إِنَّهُمْ لَفِي سَكْرَتِهِمْ يَعْمَهُونَ. This is, first of all, لَعَمْرُكَ, it's basically by your life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying to His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there's no one more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is swearing by the life of the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam, saying that they are, meaning the people of Lut, they were in their intoxication with their desires and their sinful act, they are totally oblivious of what's the outcome of their actions. They're totally immersed into the desire that they're in, the sinful desire that made them forget about everything. And therefore the punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came to them very severe. فَأَخَذَتْهُمُ الصَّيْحَةُ مُشْرِقِينَ. الصَّيْحَة, shout. Something that took and seized them in the morning, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the entire town upside down, as we heard before. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said after mentioning this, إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِلْمُتَوَسِّمِينَ. Indeed, there is ayat, signs and lessons, not for everyone, but for the mutawassimin. Mutawassimin, those who reflect, those who think, those who see things in the right way, those who would see beyond just the words. Sometimes people, they listen to these types of words, but they don't take actions or they don't take lesson as a result of this. The lesson to be learned, that the punishment is continuous. It's something that it's going to happen if people do not repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and abhor these types of evil crimes. And this is something that is going to be the case from one generation to the other, and that's why this is a sign from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the believers to repent to Allah, to enjoy good and forbid evil, to know that these evil sins would never bring anything but the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We'll go now inshallah ta'ala to Surah Ash-Shu'ara, and we've been going to Surah Ash-Shu'ara listening to some of the verses there that talks about the messengers of Allah, even though it's mentioned in brief, but it gives great benefits of how the subject or the work of the messengers of Allah, that they were sent to the people to call them to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and ordering them to do all kinds of good things and pure things and forbidding them from all evil and wicked sins. With Sheikh Karim Saudi would recite for us inshallah ta'ala in Surah Ash-Shu'ara. Please go ahead.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم كذبت قوم لوط المرسلين إذ قال لهم أخوهم لوط ألا تتقون إني لكم رسول أمين فاتقوا الله وأطيعون وما أسألكم عليه من أجر وما أسألكم عليه من أجر إن أجري إلا على رب العالمين أتأتون الذكران العالمين وتذرون ما خلق لكم ربكم من أزواجكم بل أنتم قوم عادون.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. The people of Lut, they denied the truth. They rejected the message of the messengers of Allah. When their brother Lut, one of them, he called them to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he ordered them to fear Allah, to be dutiful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because indeed he's a messenger from Allah and a trustworthy one. They know him. They know that he's a trustworthy one. And he's been sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So ordering them to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be dutiful to Allah, to be obedient to the messengers of Allah. And he's not someone that is asking for any wage or any price for his da'wah, for his inviting them to the truth. He seeks rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And all of these are signs for them that he's someone that is honest and truthful in his warning to them. And then he would explain what is the problem with the people of Lut besides worshipping other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that they would seek the pleasure with male mates and not through what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created for them, meaning having a husband and a wife, which comprises the families. They sought these evil actions, and Allah subhanahu, and they left what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created for them from their wives, and they transgressed the limits. And as a result of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala severely punished them. And the punishment of these people of Lut is one of the most severe one, because of the evil of the action that they used to do. One of the great lessons that we learn is that even though the destruction from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came to different nations according to their evil actions, and the worst crime ever, of course, is to associate partners with Allah, but the punishment that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to the people of Lut was in such a way because of, besides associating partners with Allah, they corrupted their insight. Some sins would corrupt the person completely, make the person very difficult for him to see guidance, one of which is the sin of the people of Lut. It's a sin that can really change the entire human being, his heart, to be completely filthy, that the person would continue to be in the state of disbelief, wal'iyadu billah, even though repentance is valid for them. If they return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept their repentance. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most merciful. We'll continue inshallah ta'ala with the same surah and the outcome of what happened as a result of them denying the truth. Was Sheikh Ahmed Rajab, please go ahead and recite for us.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Qalu la illam tantahi ya Lut latakunanna minal رجين. قال إني لعملكم من القالين. رب نجني وأهلي مما فنجيناه وأهله أجمعين إلا عجوزا في الغابرين ثم دمرنا مؤمنين إن في ذلك لآية وما كان أكثرهم مؤمنين وإن ربك لهو
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. And these are the verses in Surah Al-Shu'ara continuing the story of Lut alayhi salam and his people. That the people of Lut, with their sin and with their evil actions, they keep on saying to Lut alayhi salam that they would expel him. This is their way. And they wanted to expel Lut alayhi salam and his people because they are pure people. They purify themselves. And that's why those who are filthy and those who are impure, they like to associate themselves with those who are filthy and impure. And therefore the pure ones, the believers, the righteous ones, should have the company of those who are righteous. And that shows the importance of companionship. And that's why there are verses in the Quran that talks about this. And that the person would bite on his hands in the day of resurrection. Why? Because he would say that he wished that he took the messenger of Allah, that he would follow the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he would say, Ya waylata laytani lam attakhidh fulanan khalila. He would say, I wish I didn't take so and so as my intimate friend. Why? Because لَقَدْ أَضَلَّنِي عَنِ الذِّكْرِ بَعْدَ إِذْ جَاءَنِ. That he deviated me away from the remembrance of Allah after he came to me. And this is what the people of Lut they did to one another. That if someone had the zeal maybe, or the glimpse of a zeal that he wants to be among the believers, the companionship ruined this. And that's why they said to Lut alayhi salam that they want to expel him so that he does not affect others with his goodness and righteousness because they are fully corrupted. And he said to them that he hates their actions. And that's the courage of the believers and the messengers of Allah. He did not assimilate with them and approve of their actions as some even Muslims would do sometimes with those who commit sins. The matter has to be clear that as a believer, a person has to abhor sins. Sins are evil actions. Yes, he should be kind and he should advise the people and so on, but he distanced himself. That's why Lut alayhi salam, he said, قَالَ إِنِّي لِعَمَلِكُمْ مِنَ الْقَالِينَ. I hate what you're doing. I don't like what you're doing because this is evil. This is something that would bring the destruction upon you. This is something that brings the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon you. He made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save him and his family from what they're doing. He is knowing that sins brings the curse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The same thing for the believers, they should basically be the means for saving their people. If it wasn't for the believers being present on the face of earth, the day of resurrection would be occurring then. Why? Because as long as there are believers on the face of earth, there are security to their people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would not send his wrath and his punishment upon people as long as there are those who would remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as a result of that, he saved Lut alayhi salam and his people, wa ahlahu ajma'een, all of his people, all of them, except illa ajuzan fil ghabirin, the wife of Lut alayhi salam, she was punished with the people, those who were punished, because as we said, she approved what they did. She used to approve what they're doing of this evil act. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed everyone else. وَأَمْطَرْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ مَطَرًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala poured rain of fire upon them. فَسَاءَ مَطَرُ الْمُنْذَرِينَ. What a worse destination and abode for them. The rain that came down on those who were warned. So they were not basically destroyed and perished without being warned thoroughly, they were warned. That means they took their chance. And again, as we said over and over again, if someone receives a warning clearly and he doesn't act according to this warning, he should not blame anyone but his own self if he doesn't take it seriously. Right? And human beings, they take warnings very serious. If a warning comes, run from this place because there's something coming your way, it's going to kill you all. What people do, they run away. They don't even wait to see who's the one that is warning. They don't have to even make sure that he's trustworthy. They take warnings very serious. We as human beings, we take warnings very serious. So when someone like Lut alayhi salam, a messenger from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, someone that is trustworthy, the wisest among them, they know him very well, and he's coming with such warnings and severe warnings to them that a punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is coming, and they don't care, they don't take it serious, they don't go and search for the truth for themselves, then they should not blame anyone because they deserved it. That's why the ayah says, فَسَاءَ مَطَرُ الْمُنْذَرِينَ. What a worst punishment is for those who were warned. We are warned. We are warned by the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, given the glad tidings for the believers, warning those who disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, warning against sins, and that sins brings all kinds of miseries in this life and in the hereafter. So why a person should then complain because of the difficulties in life and this and that, when we already know the means to uplift this ummah by being obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when people would complain about materialistic things in this life, but they are fine with the sins and the corruption and the spread of the evil actions that brings the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made these concepts and these ways of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so clear in the Quran. What destroyed the people of Lut? It's because of their own sins. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most just. It's their sins, their disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, arrogantly, defiantly, they did not repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not a mistake here or there and then they repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is for the believers, they do that. But for the disbelievers, those who rebel against the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so severe. That's why this is an ayah, this is a sign from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not for anyone, but for the believers. Sign for us, because what is meant by these verses is ourselves, to protect ourselves from the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to stay away from these sins. You know, sins, it changes the lives of the people gradually, especially with the sin like the people of Lut. You would find societies that used to abhor this sin so much, and then eventually, step after another, it becomes part of the norm. Why? Because they didn't warn themselves from it. They didn't take precautions against it. They didn't raise their generations to see this as a sin. Then generations are raised to see what a sin is, being something permissible, something that is good for the people to do, then the religion is changed this way because of ignorance. That's why we have to spread the ilm. We have to spread the knowledge. This is something mandatory for us as Muslims. We have to be patient with the orders of Allah. Someone, when he asked a great scholar, when people see the strangeness among the lives of the people when it comes to matters of the deen, they learn matters of the deen and they want to hold fast to it, but they see at the end of the day people are not applying it. They talk about hijab and women are taking off their hijab. They're talking about sins and people are committing sins. So what should we do in these types of situations? The answer was, be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose you to be away from this. It's a great favor from Allah to be safe from these sins that many people, they fall into the trap of it. The other thing is that a person should be aware of, and that is, keep on learning the knowledge and spreading it, and be patient. Spread the truth to the people, even if you're the only one, to make the matter clear that you distance yourself from whatever the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes, a person is safe. Why? Because he is warning the people from the wrath of Allah, from the punishment of Allah as a result of the sins. And that's why we as Muslims, we need to seek the rewards from Allah, to seek the ilm, the knowledge, and to spread the truth among the people seeking the pleasure of Allah. There are many things to be said, but this is really a very serious matter with regards to these types of sins that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punished nations because of it. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us learn from this, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you for reciting these verses about Prophet Lut and the people of Prophet Lut and spreading this knowledge. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we all benefit and that we warn ourselves and others from these types of crimes that can bring the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us all. So till next time, I leave you with the care of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
لئن اجتمعت الإنس والجن على أن يأتوا بمثل هذا القرآن لا يأتون بمثله بعضهم لبعض ظهيرا. مُبَشِّرًا